Good morning, my dear students. I am going to take the revision of the topic one-dimensional heat conduction for hollow cylinder. Last I was talking about one-dimensional boundary condition, also one-dimensional heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. So though, now we have to go for the cylindrical coordinate, how the heat conduction equation is going to be derived for cylindrical coordinate. So we have to consider a steady state heat flow through hollow cylinder of uniform thermal conductivity without heat generation. The figure shows the length of the cylinder and the temperature distribution at R1 and R2, are the temperature T1, T2 and with the respective length. So now we have to consider controlling differential equation for one dimensional heat conduction equation cylindrical coordinate, that is d square T by dx square plus 1 by r dt by dr is equal to 0. So this is what the equation that I am going to take, because this is already derived, and from this I am going to derive one dimensional heat conduction equation. So now what you have to do is you have to differentiate this equation with respect to r. So if the x is there, you can take it as r here, there is a mistake, and this one is you have to take it as r. Okay, so now we'll have to differentiate this equation. You will get d by dr of r into dt by dr is equal to 0. Integrating with respect to r and temperature distribution equation, T is equal to C1 ln r plus C2 you will get. Using boundary condition at appropriate radius r1 and r2, temperatures are T1 and T2. Substituting these two boundary conditions in the equation, you will get, and after substituting those boundary condition, T1 is equal to C1 ln r C2, T2 is equal to C2 ln r C2. Now we have to add them and subtract these two equations. So T1 minus T2 and the C1 of ln R2 by R1, it is 10 to the C1 is T1 minus T2 divided by ln R1 by R2. Substituting similarly for C2, you will get this equation in this form. The same equation, go back to the equation. C1 and C2 you have to substitute in this equation, you will get the temperature distribution. So C2 value you will get like this, substituting C1 and C2 in the equation 2.23, and after simplification to a form where you will get the this temperature distribution equation in page number 40 in data handbook. This is only a simplification with a logarithmic ratio I taken. After that it should be get simplified to this version. This is also, this equation is given in data handbook. You know, the only the unknown values are temperature T and R. We know R1, R2, you know, T1, T2, you also know, because known boundary condition is substituted. Only at any value of R, you can also calculate the temperature T. Or knowing the temperature at the value of R, you can also calculate the radius. Because only the one unknowns are there in this equation, and you can calculate another unknown by substituting all the boundary conditions, known boundary condition, into this equation. So this is what it's going to be. How do you calculate the heat transfer? You can calculate heat transfer by considering the Fourier's law of thermal conduction. So the Q is equal to minus K A dt by dx at R is equal to x. Instead of x, I have to take it as R. It is wrongly by typographical error, it is R. X is equal to R, dt by dr is equal to R is equal to R1, dt by dr is equal to C1 by R. So C1 value is T1 minus T2 ln R2 by R, R1 by R2. Therefore, you can substitute this equation, and after simplification, you get the, after substituting this, area is equal to 2 pi L or pi RL, 2 pi RL surface area are taken. Note that this is the surface area, and then after substituting you will get 2 pi RL ln R2 by R1. RR get cancelled here, this R it's going to be get cancelled with that R. So this R is going to be get cancelled with this R. Okay, so you will get 2 pi L T1 minus T2 ln R2 by R1. So where R is equal to the ln R2 by R1 or 2 pi L, this is the resistance. So finally, this equation is given in data. Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R. So this is very simple, and all these three equations, this one, and temperature distribution equation is given in page number 40 of data handbook. Okay. Go to the next one-dimensional heat conduction equation for hollow sphere. So you know the study one-dimensional heat conduction equation for hollow sphere of radii R1, R2 having temperature T1, T2 at inside and outside respectively. Sphere having uniform thermal conductivity K without heat generation. Consider one-dimensional steady state heat conduction equation for hollow cylinder. The controlling differential equation is d square r by dr square, d square t by dr square plus 2 by r dt by dr is equal to 0. So this equation you have to multiply by r square, you will get d square r, d square t by dr square multiplied by r square into 2r into dt by dr. So this you have to write down in the differential form. The product function r square minus r square multiplied by dt by r into dr dt by d by dr is equal to 0. So integrating this equation with respect to r, once you will get dt by dr is equal to c1 by r square. Because r square I have taken this side and then simplified. So similarly, you have to differentiate once again, what you get? T1 is equal to minus c1 by r plus of c2. Substituting boundary condition, t is equal to t1 at r is equal to r1, t is equal to t2 at r is equal to r2. There are two temperature boundary conditions that I am going to substitute at respective locations of r1 and r2. So after substituting the t1 value, t1 c1 by r1 plus of c2. Similarly, t2 is equal to minus c1 by r2 plus c2. And adding up these two equations, it means these two equations you have to add it up, and you will get C. You have to take C1 common factor, 1 by R2 of minus 1 by R1 and T1 minus T2. Therefore, C1 is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by R2 minus of 1 by R1. So, after substituting this C1 in the above equation, you will calculate C2 here. C2 is in terms of T1 and R1, you will get this. Substituting both C1 and C2 in the equation 2.26, that is temperature distribution equation, and simplifying that to a data handbook, you will get T is an unknown factor and R is also unknown value. This is R is unknown value. By knowing the R value, you can calculate temperature T, because other parameters, what are the other variables are there in these equations are known, because you have taken it as a boundary condition, known boundary conditions. And only the two unknowns are temperature and radius. By knowing radius R, you can calculate the temperature. Or by knowing the temperature at any location of R in the sphere, hollow sphere, you can calculate the temperature. So therefore, this equation is called a temperature distribution equation with a known boundary conditions and known dimensions of radius R1 and R2. So the heat flow through the sphere can be calculated by Fourier's law of thermal conduction. So the how we are going to conduct the Fourier's law, by minus k dt by dr, where r is equal to r1. So you know that wherever I used x, you can take it as r. So here x is equal to r. X is equal to r, you can take. So its rating is very difficult. Instead of x, you can take it as r. So therefore, area is, surface area is equal to pi r square. So that is 4 pi r square minus k 4 pi r square c1 by r square. Rr get cancelled. You will get c1, you can substitute t1 minus t2 divided by 1 by r2 minus 1 by r1. Taking LCM of r1 r2, you will get 4 pi r square r1 r2. R square is also taken out here. This is again one more mistake. This r square is not there. This r square is eliminated here. See, you have to wind up this r square with this r square. So you will get 4 pi r1 r2 t1 minus t2 divided by r2 by r2 minus r1, because r square is not there. So where resistance r is equal to r2 minus r1 divided by 4 pi k into r1 r2. That way the resistance value you can substitute. So go to the next, you will take it as a composite wall with the resistance in series and resistance in parallel. There is one topic asked in your syllabus, that resistance, thermal resistance in series and thermal resistance in parallel. That I am going to take it here. See the composite wall, consider a composite wall of thickness L1, L2, L3. So three composite thickness are taken. The composite wall of thickness L1, L2, L3 of resistance R1, R2, R3 having temperature T1 from the left to right, I am keep reading T1, T2, interface temperature T2, interface temperature T3, and outside surface temperature T4. So those things are marked in the temperature gradient line. Heat is flowing like this. Finally, it passes through, it decreases, temperature decreases from left surface to the right surface. Whereas temperature and heat transfer coefficient are given at the inside and outside boundary. Okay, these are the resistance R1, R2, R. This is composite slab. So the considering the composite slab of thickness L1, L2, L3 having the thermal conductivity K1, K2, K3, which are exposed, the surface are exposed at hot and cooled. That is why HI and TI and H0 and T0 have taken outside and inside. So the energy balance equation you have to write for each slab. Each slab you have to write. First, the heat is getting conducted. Q is equal to by air it is getting conducted to a wall. Therefore, air means you have to use convective heat transfer coefficient H1, that is HI into area TI minus T1 is equal to the conduction in the first slab, that is K1A dot by L1, T1 minus T2, that is K2 again conducted to a third slab, conductivity equation you have to write. Second slab and third slab, we have to write a conductive equation with the known property, and then outside heat transfer coefficient. This is the energy balance equation, how the energy is getting conducted. Adding up all these three, all the five equation, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equations, RHS and LHS, you have to add them. You will get this way. Q by A is equal to 1 by HI plus L1 by K1 plus L2 by K2 plus L3 by K3 plus 1 by H0 is equal to T1 minus T2. So Q is equal to A, I have taken this, Q by A is equal to small q. I can write Q by A is equal to small q. Q is equal to it's very difficult to write the answer. Q is equal to small q is equal to capital Q by A, it is a heat flux, T1 minus T2, T1 minus T2 divided by the resistance R. So the for n number of composite layers, you can take TI minus T0 is equal to 1 by HI plus 1 by H0, sigma of n is equal to 1, n is equal to n divided by ln by kn. This is what the n number of cells composite you have to take. So thereby this chapter is over. I'll go to variable thermal conductivity. Coming back to the variable thermal conductivity, where the temperature distribution and thermal conductivity with the known thermal conductivity and also the heat transfer you have to calculate from this. What are things you are going to conduct derive this equation using this variable thermal conductivity in a simple Cartesian coordinate. Consider steady state one dimensional heat conduction through a slab of non-uniform thermal conductivity without heat generation. The controlling differential equation become d by dx of k into dt by dx is equal to 0, where k is equal to function of time temperature, where conductivity is a function of temperature. So that is why it is variable. Thermal conductivity is variable since it is a function of temperature. So therefore, that is equal to put k naught 1 plus alpha t in the place of k, and where alpha is the thermal diffusivity, and substituting this in this equation, this this quantity in this equation, you will get d by dx of k naught 1 plus alpha t dt by dx is equal to 0. Integrating the above equation with respect to x, so you will get k naught 1 plus alpha t dt by dx is equal to c1. So the integrating the above equation once again with respect to x again, k naught t plus alpha by 2 t square plus c1 x plus c2 using boundary condition t is equal to t1 at x is equal to 0 and t is equal to t2 at x is equal to l. First boundary condition, c2 value will get k naught t1 plus alpha by 2 t1 square. Similarly, c1 l, okay, k naught t2 plus alpha by 2 t2 square minus c2. So this again it is simplified to c1, substituting back into c1 and c2 in the above equation by taking the t mean temperature as t1 by t2 plus 2, and it takes some time to understand, and it is very lengthy one, and it convert to be a quadratic equation by using a quadratic solutions, equation solution to solve the temperature T. So you can also, this is the temperature distribution equation for variable thermal conductivity. This equation is given in data handbook. You can just have a look at it. And further to simplify, you have to practice. Students are, if you simply go through this, unless you practice, you are not able to remember anything. But it is given in the data handbook, but you know how to simplify this by integration and using boundary conditions. So using this, you can calculate the heat flow through slab with variable thermal conductivity. So again, it is getting simplified. Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx at x is equal to 0. And using variable thermal conductivity equation, so dT by dx is equal to C1 times K0 1 plus of alpha T, substituting C1 in the Fourier's law of thermal conduction equation, you will get a simplified equation in terms of the mean conductivity. This is the conductivity and into surface area T1 by, and where Km is equal to K0 1 plus of alpha Tm. This is how we have to calculate. It's going to ask this the examination for 10 marks. Steady state unidirectional heat flow through slab of non-uniform conductivity without heat generation for cylinder. For slab, but different conditions I am going to take. It means with a known heat flux at one side, Q is known to you. How you are going to solve this equation? This one case study I have taken, T is equal to T1 at X is equal to 0. And substituting that, you will get the temperature distribution like this. It is also given in the data handbook. And with a known heat flux, instead of temperature, what you have to take? Known heat flux you have to take at the other one end. Another end is a known temperature. You will get this equation like this. The another topic that he has asked in the examination, the, in your syllabus, is that unidirectional heat flow with heat generation. Heat flow through a slab of heat generation when the temperature of both sides of the walls are known. Temperature at both side walls are known and heat generation is occurring at the center. And you are taking elemental strip at a distance x from the zero, total length is L. So using the heat conduction equation, Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx. So you can further simplify. Finally, you will get an equation like this. D square T by dx square plus of Q dot by K is equal to 0. This is the one-dimensional heat conduction equation. You can directly take, instead of going through all these steps, you can directly D square T by dx square plus of Q dot by K is equal to 0. Already, I derived this equation in a three-dimensional conduction equation in Cartesian coordinate with the heat generation. Without heat generation, with heat generation, and also time functions as a Laplace equations are used, and Poisson's equation are used, and also the diffusion equation, all the three equations. So this is the Poisson's equation that I am using now. So by using this differential controlling, the controlling differential equation become d square t by dx square q dot by k x into c1 first integration. After integrating once again, you will get this equation. Using boundary condition, dt by dx is equal to 0 at x is equal to 0, c1 is equal to 0. C1 value you will get 0 in this equation because dt by dx is equal to 0. So this equation, you will get c1. And similarly, you have to calculate C2. So C2 is equal to this equation. Substituting those two in the temperature distribution equation, finally you will get T max is equal to T1 Q dot L square by 8K. This is also given in the data handbook. The what maximum temperature at the center of the slab you are going to get, that I am going to show it in the here. This is the maximum temperature, T max. This is what we have to derive by taking the temperature distribution equation. Sometimes they will ask what is the temperature distribution maximum at the center when the heat is generating in a slab of uniform thermal conductivity. So it is given in the data handbook. You can also see that. Page number 40. Now the to find out the heat flow through a slab with heat generation, it means at the center the heat is generated and it flows from the left and right side of the wall. So therefore Q is equal to Ka dT by dx at x is equal to L by 2. I taken x value is 0, I have not taken x is equal to L by 2. From the center to the wall, the length is L by 2. So that equation you have to substitute. Finally you will get Aq dot L by 2 for one side. For both sides, you will get A L Q dot. That is the amount of heat conducted out from both the surface. Total heat flow from both the surfaces, Q L total is equal to 2Q. It means A L Q dot. The volume into heat generating capacity, that is equal to heat conducted minus heat generated. How much heat is generating at the center, so much of heat is getting conducted out from the both the surface. That is what you want to prove. I proved it. Okay, you can also practice this. And there is one more condition that is given when the one wall is insulated and other wall is exposed to the ambient condition. And what are the boundary condition that I am going to take? Little effort is made to derive. Sometimes it may be asked in the examination. This is also given in the data handbook. You can try it out. Okay, that I am not going to solve it. One derivation I have taken. See the because of. This is a revision class, shortage of time. We can go through this problem. Resistance in parallel and resistance in series I have taken. So this is the best exam for resistance in parallel and resistance in series. All resistance you have to calculate, RA, RB, RC and RD. So RB and RC are in parallel, that you have to sum up. Thereby it is going to close up and I'll take it in the next slide. I don't think it is going to be. For revision, lecture number 14, 15 and 16, I am going to revise it because that is not a properly taken. Now I am going to take up the transient heat conduction equations. The transient heat conduction equations with the temperature charts. So now one dimensional steady state heat conduction equation, lumped system analysis. So why the lumped system analysis is taken? And when the body is suddenly exposed to a temperature surrounding within the how much the energy is going to be changed. It means change of temperature occurs in the body when it is suddenly exposed to the environment. And whether it is getting cooled or heated, it depends on the temperature distribution. It means whenever the body is exposed to a very high temperature, it will get absorbed the heat. When it is exposed to very cold temperature, it means very low temperature, surrounding temperature is low and the system temperature is more, heat start transferring from system to the surrounding. The surrounding temperature are more and system temperature is low, and then the surrounding heat is start flowing from surrounding to the system. This is you understood very well through concept of thermodynamics. See, the determination of temperature distribution within the solid during the transient is a more complicated matter, because temperature varies, in the body, it varies with both position and time, two variables. Previous in one conduction, one dimensional conduction equation only, the temperature varies with position only you have studied. Here, position and time both you have to study, because it is a transient state. So, in many practical application, the variation of temperature with position is negligible during transient. Hence, the temperature is considered to be varied with time only. It means wherever it is there, but the position is not an important parameter. Only time is important parameter. Lapse of time, how it is going to be get cooled or going to get heated up. Analysis of heat transfer under such assumption is known as lumped system analysis. Since the temperature is a function of time only, the analysis become very simple. Therefore, in this chapter, we are begin with a lumped system analysis for transient heat conduction. See, the transient heat conduction charts are going to be used to solve this problem. If the using certain parameter to analyze whether it is fall under lump system or you have to go for the transient temperature charts, that I am going to take up. So this is applicable for slab and cylinder and sphere. You may ask one question, why only this slab and cylinder and sphere going to solve? Why can't other geometries? Because it is only a preliminary subject, and knowledge of heat transfer is there if the students are learning, and only the fixed geometries with a known geometry, standard known geometries are going to be considered and then can be taken. If you want to study a different geometry, that is elliptical shape and even pyramid shape or whatever the other than the conventional shapes you want to study, again you will have to understand, go for the advanced heat transfer to understand. So first you have to fundamentally you have to understand this. The lumped system, how we are going to study. First you have to consider a boundary, a solid boundary with an arbitrary shape, and it is having volume A, volume V, and total surface area A, thermal conductivity K, density, specific heat and temperature, and surrounding temperature with a known time, and it should be in the well-stirred liquid and kept at temperature T0. The figure illustrates the heat transfer, because these are the property way of the system that you are considering. The arbitrary shape having a volume, specific heat, density, initial temperature and temperature T0. So the ambient temperature is mixed. This is the fluid and it is having surface area, and this is a fluid property. So this is the lumped system analysis heat transfer. This is one geometry I have taken. This is the electrical network for using the thermal network for single capacity system. It means single system there in that. So the again you are going to write the heat balance equation for system of which the figure which I shown. The rate of heat flow into the solid of volume V through a boundary surface. It means the rate it is flowing into the system or out of system. Both are considered same here. Therefore, rate of increase in the internal energy is a matter. Whether internal energy decreases or increases, it's all depend on the how you are going to take, whether it is the heating or cooling that you are going to take. Therefore, it is equated. HA T infinity minus T is equal to MCP delta T. Rho into V is the mass, CP into temperature difference with respect to time. Energy, this is the energy equation. So, after simplifying this, dividing it by D tau, and you know that area V is can be written as area into volume. That get simplified. You know that HA by rho CP you are going to take as M, and this is theta T. Wherever T is there, you can call it as theta. So the D theta T by D tau plus M of theta T is equal to 0, where M is equal to HA by rho CP V. Okay. After simplification, you will get this equation. Integrating this equation, you will get two roots, that is ln theta t is equal to minus m dot t is equal to c1. By considering the boundary condition, t is equal to t naught or t is equal to 0, where t is the initial body temperature of the solid to be cooled or heated. Both I written. It may be cooled or heated. Boundary condition that you have taken. The general solution for the above equation is theta naught is equal to c e to the power of mt, where c is substituted in the above equation. You will get theta t by theta naught is equal to e to the power of mt, where theta t by theta naught is the temperature distribution. So this equation I am going to get it. So this you have to simplify in terms of Biot and Fourier, and the geometrical ratio of non-dimensional geometry that is going to be substituted in the above equation. By only rearranging the variables in the equation, HA by rho Cp V into T can be written as modified below. Only rearranging this, finally you will get H delta by K is equal to Biot number, this is Fourier's number, and this is geometrical number. So there are three numbers are there. This is Biot number, this is Fourier's number, and this is ratio of geometry, non-dimensional geometry. So the equation is the Biot number is heat transfer coefficient of solid surface to the thermal conductivity across L. So these are all three dimensionless numbers, Fourier number, the rate of heat conducted across L in a volume, and heat storage in a volume. This is non-dimensional geometry. So this is how we are going to theoretical body will take infinite time. Theoretically, the body will take infinite time to attain a steady state. It means any object is getting heated up. If allow it to cool on a table, small object getting heated up and then allow it to cool on a table, it take very long time to cool, or the amount of energy dissipated from the surface to the surrounding takes very long time. Practically it never come to a steady state, but it's keep on exchanging heat from the surrounding. So you consider that finite time, that heating and cooling. So if the increasing m in this direction, it is only cooling. If the increasing m in the upward direction, it is heating. It means m increases, heating of body from 0 to 0 internal resistance, and cooling of body with the 0 internal resistance. It means you are considering there is no resistance at all. The mixed boundary condition is, best example for mixed boundary condition is iron box. That we are going to, because you are supplying energy in terms of heat flux, and the heat is getting dissipated to the surface of the iron box. They consider a situation, a part of the boundary surface, a region subjected to convection, and a remainder is subjected to the heat flux. It means the iron box is exposed to atmosphere where the convection boundary condition is there, and what is the energy you are inputting? It is the heat flux that you are putting into the iron box. So this is one mixed boundary condition equation I derived. I don't think this is not there for the syllabus, but anyhow, I may take an effort to solve this. Finally, you will get temperature distribution in this fashion. This is the equation 4.6 is the temperature distribution equation. Finally, you are written like this. And so how I simplified this is like this. And if you are interested, you can go through that. And this information I taken directly from Nakati Vajase. Heat transfer by Nakati Vajase. I'll take one or two practical examples to apply the lump system analysis. An aluminum plate of conductivity 160 watt per meter degree Celsius. The specific heat of the aluminum plate is 880 joule per kg. degrees Celsius. Density is 2790 kg per meter cube. Of thickness L is equal to 3 cm. And at a uniform temperature of 225 degrees Celsius, is suddenly immersed at time t is equal to 0 in a well-stirred fluid maintained at constant temperature T infinity is equal to 25 degree. The heat transfer coefficient between the plate and the fluid is 320 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Determine the time required for the center of the plate to reach 50 degree Celsius. It means how much time it will take to reach the center temperature of the plate to reach 50 degree Celsius. This is what the problem you have to solve. In this example, so first you have to check the Biot number. If the Biot number is less than 0.1, therefore it need to be applied. If it is not, then more greater than 0.1, it need not be applied, because it will have a different solution for this problem. So first you have to study the Biot number. Biot number is 3 into 10 raised to minus 2, therefore it is less than 0.1. Biot number is HLS by K, where first you have to dimensionless length you have to calculate. So volume by area, sorry, dimension LS you have to calculate. Volume by area, that is LA by 2A is equal to L by 2, therefore 3 by 2 is equal to 1.5, half the length of the slab. By substituting half length into a Biot number, you will get less than 1. Then for hence, this lump system analysis is applicable. Which is the lump system analysis equation? Tt minus T infinity divided by T naught minus T infinity is equal to e to the power of m into T, where Tt is 50 degree, that is a known temperature. How much time it will take T? Here the time is given. So this is the time, m into T. This you have to calculate time. So T infinity 25, outside temperature. Initial temperature 225. Calculate m value. After calculating m, you will get m value is equal to minus second. Then you substitute in the above equation. Time you will get 239, that is equal to 4 minutes. This is what it means. After 4 minutes, center temperature of this slab, it reaches 50 degree. This is what you understand. So by this, we will go to the next problem. The temperature of the gas stream is measured with a thermocouple. The junction may be approximated as a sphere. Diameter D naught is equal to 1 millimeter. Conductivity K is equal to 25 watt per meter degree Celsius. CP value is 400 joule per kg Kelvin. And density is equal to 8400 kg per meter cube. The heat transfer coefficient between the junction and gas stream is H is equal to 50 watts per meter square. How long it will take to take for thermocouple to record 99% of the applied temperature difference? It means 1% it cannot achieve, only 99% is asked. So to solve this problem, first you have to check the Biot number. Biot number is less than 1, then only you can use this equation, otherwise it cannot be. Hence the, you know that first you have to calculate the length, dimension length, that is 1 by 6 millimeter. Biot number is equal to HLE by K. Substituting the L value and H value and K value, you will get a Biot number is equal to 0.1, as the lump system analysis is applicable because it is less than 0.1. So the 99% of applied temperature reaches, it means 1 by 100 it is going to be reached. So 1% is 1 by 100 that I am taking. So 1 by 100 is equal to e to the power of mt. The m and t value is known to you. So temperature T you can calculate, that is 4.6 seconds. This is very simple problem, and that's so the mixed boundary conditions I am going to take with the electric household electric iron steel. Base conductivity is given, CP value, density value, and the weight is given. The base of the iron surface is, area is given. Heated from heating bed, flux is given. Initially the iron is at 20 degree. Suddenly the heating starts, the iron dissipates heat by convection from the iron surface into the ambient temperature T infinity. heat transfer coefficient of 50 watts per meter square. Calculate the temperature of iron after time t is equal to 5 minutes after the start of heating. You should know the temperature. After 5 minutes, what will be the temperature of the iron surface? What would be the equilibrium temperature of the iron to be if the control did not switch off the current? It means you know that there is a bimetallic switch is there in the iron box. It automatically gets switched off when it reaches the prescribed temperature, and so that you can iron properly. Otherwise, the cloth may get burnt out while ironing if it is if it never switch off the power. We have the temperature distribution theta T by theta naught is equal to E to the power of minus MT plus 1 minus of E to the power of minus MT divided by Q by H. This is the temperature distribution equation which I solved there. After substituting all the values, you know that the M and Q values you have to substitute. You will get temperature is equal to 133 degree Celsius. This is the equilibrium temperature. At this temperature, the iron box keep flipping. It means sometimes it offs, sometimes it switch off. If it is comes below 1 degree also, it switch on. If it goes 1 degree above 133 degree, the iron box automatically switch off. This is what it's going to. This is called the mixed boundary condition. So use of temperature charts, but the Hazer charts and Grover charts that I am going to use. Hazler and Grover together they created these charts for calculating the transient temperature distribution in a solid if the internal temperatures are no longer negligible. It means temperature gradient no longer negligible in this. Hence the lump system analysis no longer. If the in any many situation the temperature gradient with a solid is no longer negligible. It means there is a temperature gradient exists. Hence the lumped system analysis no longer applicable. That is what assumption you made. Internal resistance is zero that you have considered there. Here the internal resistance is there. With that the temperature gradient also exists. If the resistance is there, temperature gradient exists. Then the analysis of heat conduction problem involves the determination of temperature distribution within the solid as a function of both time and position, and it is complicated matter. Such problem can be analyzed by using a Hazer and Grover chart or transient temperature charts if Biot number is more than 0.1. It should be 0.1, it is not 1. It should be Biot number is equal to greater than 0.1. This is the condition that you have to see. Here it is 1, it is printed, it is 0.1. Say for slab we are going to consider, and slab limits are given. And temperature boundary condition, the time t is equal to 0. What are the temperature boundary conditions are given? When time is greater than 0, how the geometry and coordinate of boundary condition are going to be changed? And it is a time dependent heat conduction problem. So these are the two geometries that I have taken. Take 10 seconds, I'll take water and come back. Okay, let's start again. So the geometrical coordinates for boundary conditions of transient heat conduction for slab are given like this. There are two conditions I have taken. One is from the center, the length is measured minus L and plus L, that is negative coordinate and positive coordinates. When the x is taken at x is equal to 0 and L is in the positive coordinate only. And the heat flux is zero at this point. It means starting there is no temperature gradient exists at this point. And how the heat is getting conducted? It means this insulated port, you call it as. If there is no temperature gradient, means there is no heat transfer occurs. So dimensionless equations that I have written, d square t by dx square is equal to 1 by alpha dt by d. Tau, that is time t. These are the temperature dimensionless equations for dt by dx is equal to 0. This is one limit, this is another limit, and whatever the equations which I have written already represented in this figure. Dimensionless variables also given here. And this is the dimensionless temperature, dimensionless coordinate, Biot number and Fourier number. These are the four dimensionless numbers are required to represent the transient heat conduction when the temperature gradient is no longer negligible. Using Biot relation, we are going to check up whether it is a lumped system or using the temperature charts you are going to refer, that you are going to take it. Okay. For slab, I am going to solve one problem for that. A 5 cm thick iron plate, conductivity is 60 watt per meter degree Celsius. Cp value is given, density value is given, alpha value is given. Initially is at 225 degrees. Suddenly both surfaces are exposed to ambient air of 25 degrees. Heat transfer coefficient of 500 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Calculate the center temperature at time t is equal to 2 minutes after the start of the cooling. It means after 2 minutes, what will be the temperature at the center of the iron plate? Second condition is that calculate the temperature at depth of 1 centimeter from the surface after the time 2 minute start of cooling. The third condition is calculate the energy removed from the plate per square meter during this time. There are three conditions asked by giving the property of the material, and is asked calculate the temperature start of cooling, 1 centimeter at depth, and also the amount of energy removed from the square plate, it means per square meter during this time. So you know that 2L is equal to 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter, L is equal to 2.5. 2L, why I have taken the first boundary condition that I am going to take this. This figure, this is L minus L plus L, means total length is 2L. L, this is 1L and this one is another, it means it becomes 2L. So after calculating length, Fourier's you have to calculate Fourier's number. For Biot number of 4.8, Biot number you have to calculate, and x by L is 0.6 from figure. We have the temperature distribution, T minus T infinity. This is overlapped, and the same thing I am taking here. And temperature can be calculated. Temperature is equal to 135.2 degrees Celsius after the time T is equal to 2 minutes. 2 minutes are substituted here. Okay, here 2.2 minutes into 60 are taken here and substituted and calculated. So if the temperature from the surface is determined, same thing is there backside, but I could not able to, two times it is getting copied. So Biot number is equal to 4.8. in the data handbook in Kodan Raman, it is directly Biot ratio I taken. Here it is, x by L is equal to 0.6. From figure you can also calculate. So the temperature distribution you will get 0.95. From that you can calculate after time t at 1 centimeter, it means length is equal to 1 centimeter. Substitute temperature is 135. Heat loss from the plate per square meter also calculated after 2 minutes. Q by Q L you have to take, and you will get the temperature is equal to this one. The amount of heat loss also calculated by the transient temperature charts. You will get this. This I am going to take it another diagrams again. Also go out of this and then take new one, because I done some, it's very difficult to 16. I'll try with that. Yeah, here I come. I'll go back again. This one I taken. Same problem I was solving, and you know that the Biot number is equal to 0.21 and 1 by Biot is 4.8. Right, from this I am going to calculate. You know the Fourier number is 3.1. No, Fourier number is given, alpha t by L square, it is given in the data handbook. All these equations are given in the data handbook. Only thing is the student has to remember how to substitute the values, given values, diffusivity, time and length in this equation. In the equation, calculate the magnitude of this Fourier number and Biot number. Using this Fourier number and Biot number, so Fourier number is equal to 3.1 here, this is the Biot number. I'll go back to the next slide. So here Biot number is equal to 3.1, Biot number is equal to 0.0288 and Fourier number is equal to 3.1. Coming to Fourier's number 3.1 here, and then you have to take till it reaches the Biot number is equal to 0.2088 from the page number 66 of data handbook, and then turn towards the left, that is the temperature distribution coordinate, where you get T naught minus T infinity, T1 minus T infinity is equal to 0.58. So using this 0.58, come back to previous slide. So this is equal to 0.58. Theta 0, it means time position is 0 at time t. And what will be the temperature? Temperature is 141 degrees Celsius. You will get in first first condition solution I got. That is temperature T naught is equal to 141 after the start of cooling. The temperature will be 141 at the center. So temperature is at 1.0 centimeter from the surface to be determined. X by L is equal to, X is 2.5 minus of 1 divided by 2.0 is equal to 0.6 X by L value. You can directly substitute X by L is equal to 1 by 2.5. You can take So the x by l value is known to you. Using this, x by l value is equal to 0.6 and Biot number is equal to 0.288. You can take the temperature distribution from this. That is the temperature history diagram. It means for a plate of time history at any position. Time history at any position means at x is equal to 1 centimeter. So using this, I'll go to the calculation. Using that 0.95, you can substitute the known values of temperature. You can calculate the temperature of after the start of cooling from one side, 1 centimeter, that is 135.2 degrees Celsius. The heat loss from the plate per square meter, including both sides during the transient up to time t is equal to 2 minutes, is determined. First, you have to know the this is how I taken. This one again I'll repeat. So Biot is equal to this, and the x by l ratio, this you have to take 0.6 or weight it intersect that temperature distribution I have taken here. Okay, from that you know the ambient temperature, you know, initial temperature, you know, and substituting all that, you will know the temperature at 1 centimeter. Again here, Biot number, Fourier number, Biot square into Fourier number should be calculated to know the temperature, the heat distribution. From previous, you know that the heat flow, the dimensionless heat ratio you have to take from 4 years into Biot square is 0.137 from this coordinate. Here you have to start. Clearly I shown you have to go up till it reaches a Biot number is equal to 0.1. From that you have to turn towards left. Whatever the ratio you get, Q by L, Q by Q naught is equal to 0.45. 0.45 to take. Substituting Q naught is equal to MCP delta T. M is rho into A into 2L, length. Length into A is volume. Rho is the density given. CPL is known. Temperature distribution is also known. By substituting those values, you will get Q naught is equal to 35.33 into 10 raised to 6 joule is the heat lost from both the surface. Then the heat loss from the slab per square meter in 2 minutes will be calculated by using the ratio of dimensionless heat conduction. From that you can calculate 15.9 into 10 raised to 6 joule is the amount of heat lost. See other charts I used in HDR charts using, then I used to refer the maximum the Ozasek. From there I have taken many problems and I solved them, but to convert them into a conventional data handbook, that is Kodandraman, it requires again recalculation. One problem I shown on graph how we have to solve. The problem remains same, but answers also will get the same answer. Only thing is that for cylinder and sphere, same charts are used, where the charts are available from Kodandraman. Same charts I used. Thereby, I wind up this class.